childhood experience.
What are some of those early childhood experiences that you would think that we should, as necessity and root, expose our children to, our young children to?
Yeah. When we talk about early childhood development and certainly stimulation, we're not thinking in a traditional sense. When people think about learning, is about learning ABCs and 1, 2, 3. We're talking about basic skills of learning through play, learning through experiences.
Can I stop you?
Sure, sure.
I'll tell you why I want to stop you there. Because in the Caribbean, and we have it even with our students who are talented to be sports people, that the average parent thinks that play is a waste of time.
Oh, absolutely.
How do we change that?
Well, interestingly, that's what the average parent thinks. But the parents who are perhaps best educated and most financially able know that they send their children to schools like Montessori schools, where play and self-expression are integral to the stimulation experience. Yeah.
But how do we change it? Because right there, I think, is a fundamental point of contact if you're going to make a change here.
Yeah.
That people have to think, to understand that it's important. Even young children, they play too much. That's what they're told. Yeah. How do we change that?
I think that's where programs like the Roving Caregivers Program, which is a Caribbean model for Caribbean people, will make a meaningful difference.
What is this program?
This is a home visitation program developed here in the Caribbean. It was replicated from Jamaica and has been piloted here in St. Vincent now for close to 5 years. Mm-hmm. Now, this model affords the opportunity for parents within their own home environment to be exposed to the importance of play, of talking to their children, of singing songs, and just even basically just interacting with them in very simple, uncomplicated fashions. So young persons from within communities, and we are in a number of communities here in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, are trained on how they can demonstrate to parents the effectiveness of this type of an approach. So we're talking about playing games, for example. Children from very young using manipulatives just even to develop the gross and fine motor skills. You know, something as basic as kicking a ball, you know, helps a child to develop coordination and ability to you know, use the gross motor skills. So programs that bring these experiences to parents that don't have the resources to buy Montessori type experiences for their children, now we are seeing a shift in their own thinking because they recognize, well, my child is responding to play. He or she is learning because they're playing. And because now I'm talking to them more, they're hearing more words. So therefore my child develops his or her ability to express themselves better because I myself am talking more. I'm singing songs, so I'm engaging, I'm interacting with my child now. So that bonding that takes place is critical.
That's what we do. We 0 to 5, we kind of ignore that. Mm. And then suddenly they get into kindergarten, and the first thing the parents are looking for is the child's ability to write.
Oh, yes.
To count.
Yes.
To
spell the name. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Is that totally followed up?
Oh, yeah.
But to bring the thing down to its simplest equation, Susan spoke about the kinds of stimulation that happens in something like the Roving Caregivers program. I mean, in the Roving Caregivers, for example, a rover would visit, and there's something like a pillow that they have, which is anybody can make at home. Mm-hmm. It has a pocket, it has a zip, it has eyelets for listen. And what the child does, you know, they're playing with the kid, but the child is learning to zip, to lace, to button. And these things, while they may appear to be just play, they are very important motor skills that later on, when you come to having to write, you have more control, right, over the pen or pencil. So, you know, it's those simple foundational things, and the whole thing of curiosity, asking questions, children being alive to the environment, you know, not just reacting to sensory impulses, but actually observing and noting what is around them. All these powers of observation, they've cultivated at that early stage. I mean, even from a scientific point of view, the whole theory of brain, not theory anymore, the research on brain development is showing how all of that stimulation actually affects the texture and structure of the brain and helps student people to become more observant, more critically aware, and so on.
Many parents have complained that they have gone off and bought this expensive toy for the kid, and the kid ended up playing with the corks from the soda bottle.
Yes,
and
yes.
They want to know what's wrong.
Yes.
I bought this
because
kid.
The imagination is more powerful than the mechanical
exactly,
device.
Exactly. Yeah.
So really and truly, we can spend that money doing simpler things.
Oh, absolutely. And under the Roving Caregivers program, if you see the complement of toys and manipulatives, these are all made from what we consider trashable materials. It's no high-tech, you know, Mercedes-Benz car or anything like that. It's a box from a cereal box that you might put some wheels on, and children use their imagination. And that's where creativity comes into play, because children are allowed the space to be creative with very basic things and concepts. And at the same time, parents are shown you don't need to go into town and buy, you know, expensive toys to excite your child's curiosity or to occupy their minds and allow for them to express themselves through basic things like the pillow and soft balls that can be made just from used material, and a sock can become a puppet. And parents need not be literate to tell a story. We in the Caribbean are great storytellers.
Absolutely.
So it's really about using that oral tradition and encouraging parents, tell your child a story about when you were a child. Use the puppet to, you know, even excite them a bit more as
and
you
listen,
tell that
we
story.
We grew up knowing that jumbie stories
exactly.
work the imagination very well.
Thank you.
I mean, to the extent that you didn't want to leave the bed to go to the bathroom in the night, but it did something for your thinking.
Exactly. We and don't tell
I mean,
stories
I mean,
anymore.
Even a simple thing like talking to your child.
Yeah.
All right? There are parents who really don't talk to their
to
kids.
Children.
If they do speak to their children, they talk in baby speak.
In baby language.
Yes.
Baby language, which is demeaning because you're actually assuming where the baby is at, and then you're speaking in that language.
Yes.
So you're not giving the child an opportunity to expand
to reach
its vocabulary
to you.
Exactly.
And, to,
yeah.
and to broaden its horizon.
Yeah.
So just the carrying out of what is a normal conversation with your child, often and frequently enough, begins to help them in listening, they're able to interact socially.
Mm-hmm.
There's a whole lot of stuff that goes into a simple act like that.
Yeah.
Let's take our second break. And this edition of Up Next. It's exciting, I feel excited. I hope you are, because these are some simple things, critical, but it's about child development. We'll be right back in just a moment. Don't go away. It's time. How much? Susan Branca, Dr. Judith.
Didacus.
I don't know if it's going to say Judicus. Let's go. Susan Branca, Dr. Didacus Jules, our guest on this edition of Up Next, and we are talking about early child development, seeming to zero in on its importance and to let you become aware of how important it is and what you need to do and how you could help. How you could help. We launched in St. Vincent and the Grenadines this week a foundation. What's that foundation? What are its objectives? You're the chairman, tell us.
Well, very simply put, the foundation is about, think of the foundation as a, I don't know if you call it Lendhander in St. Vincent, cooperative effort where everybody
we call it Susuhan.
Susuhan,
yeah.
Okay.
Think of the foundation as a Caribbean Susuhan whose objective is to help